Okay, here we go. You know that the aperture can make images brighter or darker. What you don't know yet is that you can achieve amazingly different looks by changing the aperture. Like this image. Or this image. But to do that, you first need to take control over the aperture. So now we're gonna leave the automatic mode for the very first time. Let's turn your control dial and select A or AV depending on your camera. How does that feel? It's great! A stands for aperture priority and tells you that you can now choose the aperture yourself rather than letting the camera decide. Your camera doesn't know what you want to shoot, so why let it decide? Now you choose the aperture and the camera takes care about the rest, adjusting shutter speed and maybe ISO to properly expose your image. Next, we'll do a short experiment. Choose two appropriate objects you want to capture. I'll take two screw anchors, put it on the table, and make sure it is far enough for the camera so that the camera can still focus. By the way, every lens has a different close focus distance. This can be a few inches for macro lenses or several feet for others. We will hear more about that in a later chapter though. We are not there yet. Let's take the second object and put it a little further back. Let's say one hand. Now it's time to take two images. For the first image, we will make your aperture big. Turn your dial, it is probably the front dial, and make the number you can read on your display as small as possible. For some that will be 3.5, for others 5.6. If you have a more expensive lens, it might also be 1.8. It depends on your lens. It sounds weird to make the number small to have a big opening, but don't let that confuse you right now. That will clear up soon. Ready? Let's start. Try not to move the camera and press the shutter. In order to correctly expose the image, your camera will choose the appropriate shutter speed. Depending on the amount of light in your room, it can be faster or slower. The next step. Without moving the camera, turn your dial in the opposite direction, making the number for the aperture as big as possible. That should be somewhere near 22. And again, press the shutter without moving the camera. Don't be surprised if the shutter speed this time is much longer. You closed the aperture pretty much, so the camera is compensating for that. A side note, if your camera didn't focus on the front object, you will need a little more control over your focus. We'll cover that later in this movie. So, that was our experiment. Let's look at the pictures. Our images are not very spectacular, but they show you one thing. The object in front is sharp in both images, but what about the object in the back? It is more blurred in the first image, but sharper in the second one. And the same with the background. It is more blurred in the first image than in the second image. Photographers call that depth of field or depth of focus. Now, what can we do with our new knowledge? Let's get creative in the next movie. Remember what you learned in this movie? For the first time, you left the auto mode and set the aperture by yourself. Congratulations!